Hi everyone, welcome to the new video of analogies which is brought to you by KettleMind. From this video onwards, we'll be starting off with the new concept of analogies which is letter-based analogies. And specifically in this video, we'll be learning about letter-number analogy under the letter-based analogy tab. As I've been saying in the prior videos of analogies, analogies is a very important topic from the exam point of view because you find a lot of questions coming in the exam. So one needs to have a very strong grasp over this concept in order to ace different competitive exams. So in this video, we'll be doing three questions and we'll try to understand that what kind of questions comes in the exam and what kind of approach should we have in order to evaluate such questions. So letter number analogy is an analogy where you'll find a relation between the letters as well as numbers. So we have to determine the relation between letters and numbers in the analogy given. And once we get the relation, we have to imply the same relation in the other half of the question in order to evaluate this question mark. And what I've said just now is the same thing that is written in the blue text on your screen. So moving on to the questions now, let us start with the first question. The first question says, you have a question that B cross H is related to 4 cross 8. On the similar lines, what is M cross Q related to? Right? Get the question right? So the question is, it says that D cross H is related to 4 cross 8. Right? On the similar lines, what will M cross Q be related to? So if you see, so one thing to start off with, in letter number analogies, if we have learnt this alphanumeric table that we've been discussing in other number series videos as well. Or series, you can say. So in alpha number table or series, every alphabet in the alphabet series in the English language is marked with a corresponding letter to it. So let's say we start off with A with 1, B with 2, and we go on with on the same lines till Z, which is marked as 26 since we had 26 alphabets in the alphabet series. So if you see in this given question, what is it marked as? So D is marked as 4, right? And H is marked as 8. So if you see in this in alpha number series, D is already 4 and H is already 8, right? So this has been marked accordingly in the alpha number series, right? So what was the pattern that we have found here? So series is, or analogy is based on alpha number series, right? Alpha numeric series, right? So on the same lines, if I talk about M cross Q, M cross Q should also follow the same pattern, right? In order to evaluate this question mark. So M corresponds to 13 and Q corresponds to 17, right? M corresponds to 13 and Q corresponds to 17. So this question mark gets replaced by 13 cross 7, right? 17, sorry, right? And if I go by the options, the third option says the same thing, right? So the answer is right. And I hope that this question is clear, that what are we trying to do in this question, right? So we first check the pattern that what this analogy follows. So since it was a letter number analogy, we started off with the alphanumeric series and we tried out that if it is based on the alpha number series itself or not. So once when we matched it with the alpha number series, so in the question it was matched, D was matched to 4 and H was matched to 8, which is according to the alpha number series. So we got to know that this analogy is simply based on the simple alphanumeric series. So now that we have determined the pattern, we moved on and we implied the same pattern on the other part of the analogy with that which has M cross Q, making it equal to 13 cross 7, right? Right? So now moving on to the next question, let us understand again that what are we trying to say in this concept by the help of one more question. So now the question given to me is, apple is related to 50 and orange is related to what on the same lines, right? So one thing which is important here is that whenever you find letter number based analogies, you will find a lot of questions coming up on the addition of digits making it equal to the number part. So what I mean to say here is that you will find that the letters of the alphabet word here, the letter word, you will find the sum of digits making it equal to the number on the right hand side in comparison to it, right? So if I talk about the sum of digits here, sum of digits of apple, sum of letters, sorry, as per alpha number series. So if you see, A is 1, P is 16, again 16, L is 12, and E is 5, making it equal to 50, right? And which is what it has been compared to, right? In the analogy, the sum of letters as per the alpha number series is compared, right? So now that we have evolved, now that we have the pattern that on which this analogy is based out, we can evaluate the other half of the analogy, which is orange. So orange is related to which number now? So on the following on the same lines, similarly, so we'll imply the same logic there as well, right? So now implying the same logic on the second half, orange is, O is 15, right? As you can see in this alpha number series, O is 15, R is 18, A is 1, N is 14, G is 7, E is 5, right? So now when you add on to these, 16 plus 18 is 34, 34 plus 14 is 48, 48 plus 7 is 55, and 55 plus 5 is 60, right? So according to this logic, this question mark should be replaced with 16 now, right? And if I go by the options, the first option also says the same thing, right? So hence my answer is right. So did you get it? What did we do in this question? We've discussed the critical points here. So in this specific question, talking about this question specifically, the number was the sum of letters as per the alphabet number series. So the pattern was sum of all the alphabets of the word as per the alphabet number series, which was compared to its sum, right? So since we derived from apple, which was equal to, which was compared to 50. So on the similar lines, on the same lines, we evaluated the question mark, making it similar to orange, right? Right? So let's do the last question for this video and let us evaluate ourselves if there's any other doubt that is left in this concept for us. So moving on to the last question. So in this question, you see F is compared to 216. So it says that on the same lines, what should L be compared to? So one thing that we should keep in mind is that when a single alphabet is compared with a very large number, you'll find either square or a cube for a number. I'll write it here. Hint, as in hint. So whenever any alphabet is compared to a very large number, then the high chances are there that we are talking about squares or cubes, right? We're talking about squares or cubes, right? So now let us see this question. So in this question, F is compared to 216. So F as per the alphanumeric series stands with 6, right? So F is 6. So 216, do you find any relation between F and 216? Or in other words, 6 and 216? Yes. When I say 6 and 216, 216 is equal to 6 cube, right? So do you find the relation now? You get the relation. Second number is the cube of first number. cube of first number corresponding to the alphabet, right? As per the alphabet numeric series, right? So now talking on the same lines, in order to evaluate this question mark, I will have to do the Q for L, the corresponding value of L. So L has a value of 12. 12 square is, I have to cube 12, right? 12 square is 144, and when I multiply 144 with 12, I get 1728. So this question mark now gets replaced with 1728, right? And if I go by the option, the first option also says the same thing, right? So hence my answer is right. So we've done three different type of questions in letter number based analogy, and I hope that it is clear to you. Also, I would really recommend you to practice more on this concept, because from the exam point of view, as said earlier, it is very important. So you can log on to KettleMind app. You'll find the link in the description below. So go to the app, visit the app, evaluate a lot of questions, evaluate yourself on a lot of questions which are listed under the same concept on the app. You can also do the comparative analysis between you and your friends and you and your family while you play the quiz using the multiplayer feature. So that's a very good feature where you get to evaluate yourself in comparison to others, that where do you stand out really. So that is it for this video. I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much.
We're introducing KettleMind, which provides you with personalized brain training. Here's how it works. Practice 10 minutes every day. Track your progress over time. Play with friends and family, and see where you stand. KettleMind has 25 fun and interactive learning games to improve your skills. As you play, you can track your performance on a daily basis. Additionally, you can challenge and compete with your friends and family on multiplayer. KettleMind helps you to increase attention span, process and retain information, learn and remember, as well as enhance reasoning and decision-making skills. Download from Google Play right now.